some episodes by watching Your People. Mm. And one of the premises of the movie, which gets debunked because racism is evil, is blacks and whites can't get along. And his best friend's a black lesbian. In the movie, they do a podcast together, uh-huh. Jonah Hill's best friend. And she's like, yo, the thing about white people is it's like a relationship where you cheated. So if you was in a relationship and you were with your man and your man fucked around on you, you'd be like, every time you with him, you're like, so did you 69? Did you fuck your ass? Like, and even if you forgave him, it would still be in the back of your mind.
Oh, Jesus.
He did that to you. And it's the same with black.
Oh my God!
Slavery, because no matter how long we get, how well we get along, we're always like, "Yeah, but you did that thing."
No, no, that's not the same.
And where does that end? Like with Scots and the English?
I wouldn't give a shit.
Scots are mad at the English because of Braveheart.
Never mind going back a bunch of generations. I wouldn't give a shit if my girlfriend's mother cheated. Like, doesn't that seem to be
yeah,
it?
That's it's logical. Like,
imagine now you're pissed because her great-great-great-great-grandmother cheated.
Right.
Now, you're, obviously, they're talking about more than cheating, slavery, and what. But I don't see as how it's any different when it's so separated by time and generations that it would make any bit of fucking difference.
I wouldn't give a shit, and this is really going out on an edge here, and I'm not sure a lot of people agree with me.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't give a shit if the woman I married used to be a slut.
Used to be a slut.
Yeah.
You're talking no degrees of separation.
It's not fantastic, but whatever. I didn't even know you then. But slavery 400 years ago?
Yeah, yeah. What movie were you talking about?
You People.
Okay. It's now, this is the one where Jonah Hill
and...
Is marrying Eddie Murphy's daughter?
Correct.
Yeah, I saw the trailer for the... I see the ad for it. Yeah, here it is. I see the ad for it on Netflix. I'm going around. I go, Jonah Hill. He's a funny guy. I play the trailer. By the end of the trailer, I had this face on.
De Niro.
I was so like, ugh, fuck you. I was angry at the television.
Well, they lure you in. Look, she's...
Yes, they lured me in.
She's a rap groupie. She has two kids. Lil Wayne's kid and Nipsey Hussle's kid. The actress, I mean.
Yeah, yeah.
But basically, spoiler alert, the movie is actually just Jonah Hill trying to get his black card.
Right. He's trying to get his black card. This is Jonah Hill as a Jew with insanely Jewish parents and grandparents. Actually, yeah. I think isn't the grandfather from Independence Day? David, my son, David.
He makes a very brief cameo,
But it is... In his briefest of cameos, he puts as much Judaism out there as he can.
Oh, yeah, always.
It's Judd Hirsch.
Yes.
David, my son, David.
Hi, David.
David.
Oh, he's going to save the world, he is.
So they Jew him up so much, and then he's got to deal with, Eddie Murphy. Now, by the way, I from the trailer, and am I right here? Julia Louis-Dreyfus is mm-hmm. his mom.
Who's not Jewish, by the way.
Who's not Jewish. Eddie Murphy is the dad of the girl.
The hot, sorry to keep interrupting you. The black chick is more Jewish than Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
Than Julie Louis-Dreyfus. Are either of them... Oh, wait, no, that's not Judd. Oh, no, that's...
Judd Hirsch is in it, though.
Judd Hirsch is in it, but that's Barney Miller.
Boom, ba-da-doom, ba-da-doom.
So are Eddie Murphy even in this a lot?
Yeah, he is.
Oh, okay. Because it said and with on the credits. With Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
Oh,
and
he's a pretty big part.
So I was like, okay, all right. Okay.
He definitely did not memorize his lines.
No.
Which I kind of like.
He didn't give a shit.
It's very Curb Your Enthusiasm. You can all tell right. A lot of those just like loose guides. But the white people are bumbling buffoons who are always saying, you wouldn't believe the horrible racist things.
Oh, but they don't know. It's just their privilege.
I don't want to repeat it on this show because I don't want you to get canceled.
No, I don't either.
But... All right, I'm just going to go for it. At one point...
Disclaimer.
Jonah Hill's mom asks the black woman how she got her hair like that.
My God. And they're just horrified,
and as
right?
she's saying that, Jonah Hill's like, Mom, shut up.
They're just horrified, right? Right?
And then the mom goes, Julia Louis-Dreyfus goes, you know, police brutality.
Oh, I saw that.
And he's like, oh, Mom, can I talk to you for a second?
You might wonder how I got in this position.
She
yep, that's
drags
me.
Her into the kitchen.
Oh,
she's trying to kiss black ass. Yeah. And that's what she gets in shit for.
By the way, that's what liberals do.
Right.
They kiss black ass.
It's weird because you kind of like that. You're lampooning liberals for kissing black ass.
Yeah.
But then you realize, oh no, you're saying that you should kiss black ass. You just got to do it better.
He should look at his mom and go, great, thank you, mom. Yes.
Yeah. It starts out kissing black ass wrong, and the moral of the movie is, no, kiss black ass right.
The right way. Right. Oh, boy. Like I said, they kind of wrote me in with just the thing. It said, Jonah Hill, it's like you people, and then the premise. And I'm like, all right, maybe, you know. And I watched the trailer, and like I said, by the end of it, I had a face. I was pissed. I was just like, shut the fuck up. This looks terrible.
Some of the banter is pretty good. Like, his sister, he's got tattoos. He's dressed kind of like me. And his sister goes, you look like a dad who lost his son at Coachella.
Ooh, that is funny.
That's not bad.
That's
funny. And he goes, you look like you run a Jewish rabbinical school at Hogwarts. And she has like round glasses.
All right, that's
a black thing.
See, that's funny. Why can't you put that in a good movie?
Yeah.
Funny lines like that.
Oh, the cucking.
He's trying to get his black card.
Hey, white people, cucking. I got some news for you. Black people don't want to be your friend. Black people don't want to be black people's friends.
No.
Like the guy who directed it, Kenya Barris or something like that.
Can you get out of my neighborhood?
He doesn't get along with black people. Like, what do black people do when they make a lot of money? They go to New Jersey. Like, rock and everything. So it's exactly like white people who want to be Indians' friends.
Right.
And they want to get an Indian name and shit.
Why is it? Why do white people feel this compulsion to get into another group and have them accept them and love them, and they will cater to them and pander instead of just being like, yeah, hang out with white people.
It's awesome. My life's work.
Yes.
It's my biggest obsession.
Yes.
Most of the people I talk to go, it's the Jews have brainwashed us. And I'm like, really? Germans in Stuttgart can't wait to get to an Indian powwow in Madison, Wisconsin. I don't know if the Jews have that kind of reach in your octopus diagram.
I have never seen a group of people, a culture, a race of people, the Germans, Germany, that have so cucked themselves
from
insanely I think as far as the spectrum from, you know, the 30s Germany till now. And the change that has happened over that time is insane. They are the most bow down, come on in, fuck our nation up. We deserve it. Like, they really.
No, but Europeans in general, like, if you go to, I did do this, but if you went to like Glasgow, Scotland with a black dude who didn't look like an African right off the boat, like he's got like blonde hair, dyed blonde, and like a hipster shirt that says The Strokes.
Right.
Or something. That guy could be 45. He's going to be fucking every 20-year-old.
Oh, Jesus.
From here to Wales and back again.
Ah, Wales.
Lee Scratch Perry, great reggae guy, producer from, you know, 60s, 70s, Kingston, Jamaica. Very talented dude. He just goes to Sweden now. He lives in Sweden and, like, makes millions of dollars just existing because they worship the ground he walks on.
Yeah.
If you're an ugly black person, go to Europe, go to Britain, go to fucking Japan, and you'll be drenched.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, that is probably amongst the most homogenous nations.
Yes.
I didn't think they appreciated it.
I bet you the new generation, Zoomers and Millennials, they can't wait to get a fucking black boyfriend.
Yeah, yeah.
But there's something about, like, when Japanese get successful, they're like, I'm rocking.
Yeah, yeah.
Mexicans, like, I think the third richest man in the world, he's actually Lebanese, but he's Mexican. The guy who